visions of you, baby.
Please be seated. Welcome to our 2017 OGRA Awards Luncheon. This is an opportunity to honor municipal, provincial, and private sector employees who have contributed many years to the betterment of roads in Ontario, and to present some special awards. Would you please rise for the blessing and remain standing for a toast to the Queen? We thank thee for ever earthly good, for life and health and family, and for our daily food. Amen. And now, if you would, please, let's toast to the Queen. And now, a toast to Canada. Thank you. Please be seated. There won't be any more ups and downs. It is now my pleasure to introduce the head tables. Please hold your applause until I have introduced everyone. First, Linda McCausland, Assistant Deputy Minister, Provincial Highways Management. Ken Lope, OGRA First Vice President. Luke Duval, OGRA Second Vice President. Brian Lewis, Chair of the OGRA Member Services Committee. Joe Turney, the OGRA Executive Director, and his lovely wife, Alana. Ladies and gentlemen, your head table. Let's have a round of applause. Unfortunately, Minister Del Duca was not able to join us today, but we would like to sincerely thank Assistant Deputy Minister McCausland for joining us. Your support of OGRA is truly appreciated, and we look forward to continuing our great partnership. So please enjoy your lunch.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Brian Lewis, and I apologize for interrupting lunch, but we must do this in order to get done in an efficient time. I'm the chair of the OGRA Member Services Committee and your Master of Ceremonies for today's luncheon. It has been said that roads, bridges, and other civilian infrastructure are the most tangible evidence of governments working on our behalf. However, what most people don't see are the legions of men and women working behind the scenes to design, build, maintain that infrastructure. This awards luncheon recognizes their contributions to the wonderful quality of life that we enjoy here in Ontario. It is also an opportunity for us to acknowledge the work of the many volunteers who serve OGRA in countless ways throughout the year. And lastly, we're here to pay tribute to the future when we give out our Scholastic Achievement Awards. Pay attention, folks. We could be working for some of these young people, and you have to call them boss. And it may happen sooner than we think. I'd like to call upon President Rob Burley and Executive Director Joe Tierney to please come forward. And if I could, I apologize in advance. As much as I've read the script over, I apologize in advance if I mess up a name, because not everybody here today is Smith and Jones. In our special awards category, it is our first award is to a longtime supporter of the OGRA conference. Paul Spears has for years been recognized as the official piper for OGRA. Paul has been blowing his pipes for OGRA since 1985, but his affiliation with the association is much older than that. Paul has been attending OGRA conference for 50 years, 28 as a delegate from the provincial government, where he worked for the Ministry of Municipal Affairs, and another 22 post-retirement, helping out on the registration desk. This year will mark 32 years of piping for OGRA. Paul has also spent 14 years as a member of council for the City of Orillia. OGRA would like to take this opportunity to extend our deepest appreciation to Paul for his years of service and support, and would ask you to come forward and receive a small gift and as a token of our appreciation. Paul? Well done, young man. And this award doesn't mean you're done, because I know you're coming back a couple times. Our next award is what we call bittersweet. I would like to ask Heather Crewe to come to the stage. This lady puts together the program, and I can guarantee you these pages were not in here when she gave me the book. The Ontario Good Roads Association has been blessed over the years with some truly remarkable employees. It is not uncommon for an employee to stay with OGRA for 20 years or more. You typically do not find that kind of loyalty anymore, and is an indicative of what a great organization OGRA truly is. OGRA is very pleased, but at the same time saddened, to announce that Heather Crewe, our manager, professional development and training, will be retiring at the end of July of 2017. Heather joined OGRA on October 14, 1996. Along with her team, have grown OGRA's education program into one of the best and most coveted effective programs in Canada. OGRA courses have been taught across Canada and even abroad. And thanks to Heather's efforts, OGRA has earned the reputation of being an expert when it comes to infrastructure training. Heather graduated from the University of Toronto with a BA in Social Sciences and a Master's degree in Adult Education from the Central Michigan University. Prior to joining OGRA, Heather worked for the Ministry of Transportation. Heather has overseen the development and delivery of many new courses during her tenure, two of which were recognized with the Transportation Associations of Canada Educational Achievement Award. OGRA Snow School, which was developed in cooperation with the Ontario Road Salt Management Group, received the TAC Award in 2007. And just recently, OGRA's Academy for Municipal Asset Management won the same award. Heather will be missed by her colleagues at OGRA and the many volunteers that she's worked with over the years. This will be Heather's last conference at as an OGRA employee, but not necessarily her last conference forever. It is a great pleasure that we, with unanimous support of the OGRA board and staff, we award Heather Crewe an honorary life membership with OGRA. Please join me in congratulating Heather. We extend our best wishes as you move into the next phase, which you're keeping a secret from all of us. Our next award is named in the memory of a longtime OGRA employee, Elaine Robinson. Our next award recognizes one special volunteer for outstanding service to the association and strong support for our mandate. Nominations are solicited from the volunteers themselves, and the winner is selected by the OGRA's nominating committee. We are extremely pleased to announce that this year's recipient of the 2016 Elaine Robinson Volunteer of the Year Award is Donald Johnson, Deputy Chief Building Official for the Town of Tillsonburg. Don is a graduate of Civil Engineering Technology Program at Fanshawe College and has a BA in Political Science from Western University. He began his career in the Roads Division in the City of London, but quickly moved to the Building Division, where he remained for 10 years. In 1991, he moved to the Town of Ingersoll, serving as their Chief Building Official until his retirement in 2013. Since retiring, Don has worked short-term contracts for several municipalities, most recently the County of Norfolk, and currently with the Town of Tillsonburg. Don began volunteering as an instructor at the C.S. Anderson Road School for OGRA in 1986, and has been instructor in the Municipal Survey Course ever since. Unfortunately, Don could not be with us today to receive his award. Don't feel bad for him, he's in Florida. We will, however, be making a special presentation to him at the Road School in May. So we acknowledge and thank Don very much for service to OGRA, and we'll make sure he gets that award. Enjoy the rest of your lunch, and I'll be back shortly with more awards. Thank you. Testing. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed your lunch. Would the recipients of the following awards please proceed to the Toronto Room, which is to your left beyond the back doors that we came in, and that is the College Proficiency Awards, Michael Woodcroft Memorial Award, and the Scott McKay Award. Would those recipients please report to the Marshalling Room in the Toronto Room at the back. Thank you. Would the recipients of the Long Service Awards please proceed to the Ontario Room, which is to your right beyond the doors. So as you go out the doors, please turn right to the Ontario Room, and that are the recipients of the Long Service Awards. Photographs will be taken at that time, so you might want to remove your name badge and leave it at your table. At this time, I would like to call upon President Rob Burley and Executive Director Joe Tierney to please come forward. Our next award is the John Neerdra Better Practices Award. This award showcases the ingenuity of municipal employees and their contributions to better practices for the municipalities. OGRA holds an annual competition to recognize innovations and the best practices that were implemented and resulted in improved efficiencies for municipal transportation and public works services and operations. This year we have two awards to present. The first award goes to the City of Toronto in the Innovative Management Practices category. Social media has facilitated public engagement, including citizens' ability to complain. Each time, that's unique and different in the political world. Each time the City of Toronto closes the Don Valley Parkway for maintenance, that's not in preparation for toll roads, is it, sir? It is bombarded with questions as to why. Consequently, the city determined that showing the public the maintenance work being done would be a great way to provide them with better perspective. The city used a drone to record maintenance activities and give the public a bird's eye view of what is being done. It was a powerful communications tool that was carried out in an effective manner and effective cost. Numerous hours of film were edited down to 3-minute video and posted for public viewing. With over 25,000 views, there was an immediate positive response from the public. This resulted in a significant reduction in complaints about the expressway closures and the work being done. The drone video became an excellent summary of work for the archiving purposes. The unedited version was used by city staff to review quality assurances, health and safety, and has opened up numerous possibilities to use this technology in planning for the future work. In the end, the city's district communications center was more effective than ever in communicating to the public, and the hope that it is using drones to capture work activities will be utilized in the upcoming expressway closures and other significant infrastructure projects. Here to accept the award are Sylvia Doe and Jonathan Matson. Congratulations to both of you, to the whole team at the City of Toronto. Congratulations again, and thank you. The next award goes to the Region of Waterloo for their entry in the Innovative Services Delivery, Maintenance and Construction Activity category. The Region of Waterloo submission was based on a project that included the rehabilitation and widening of 1.2-kilometer section of Sprague's Road, a main route between the City of Cambridge and the Town of Paris. The existing road is a rural two-lane roadway with composite concrete and asphalt pavement. Comprehensive field investigations determined that the 80-year-old concrete base was generally in good condition and should be preserved as part of the project. The final pavement design consisted of reprofiling the existing asphalt surfaces to meet the proposed design gradients, installation of an asphalt intermediate separation layer, and the placement of an unbonded concrete overlay, a rehabilitation treatment unique in Ontario. The region realized a 20% saving on the initial construction cost, versus conventional full-depth road reconstruction. Here to accept the award from the region of Halton, or pardon me, that's me, the region of Halton, from the region of Waterloo is Eric Saunderson. Congratulations to the team at the region of Waterloo for setting aside the conventional, implementing this innovative, cost-saving approach. Take back our congratulations, Eric. Thank you. In the long-term retiring course directors program, OGRA's education program relies on the technical expertise and organizational talents of a special group of volunteers who serve as course directors. They contribute countless hours updating the curricula, organizing and contacting presenters, setting and marking exams, and attending the entire course to ensure the course delivery goes smoothly. It's a privilege to recognize the efforts of three of these very special volunteers this year. Our first retiring course director award is going to a gentleman who has served us at the Guelph Road School for 14 years. Ken Beckings first got involved in the TJ Mahoney Road School course in the fall of 2003. He generally covered the technical modules on the third day of the course and could always be counted on to help proctor the exams on Wednesday afternoons. In addition to his work with the Road School, Ken is also the course director for Asset Management of Bridges, which is part of the Academy for Municipal Asset Management. In real life, Ken is the Director of Operations and City Engineer for the City of Owen Sound. Thank you, Ken, from all of us for your dedicated service. Ken? Our second retiring course director also spent many years on the TJ Mahoney Road School instructor team. Damon Wells started with the course in 2002 and was a mainstay at the Road School for 15 years. Damon not only covered off several of the technical modules, but was always one of the first instructors to arrive to help us process the hundreds of Mahoney students who came to pick up their student binders on Sunday afternoon. When he's not slugging boxes of those huge Mahoney course binders at the Road School registration, Damon is actually Director of Public Works for the City of Kingston. Damon, many thanks for all of your years of service at the Road School. You will be missed. Damon? Another one of our major educational programs is the Municipal Infrastructure Training Program. Our third award of recognition goes to David Ukeni, who contributed many hours of personal time over the years to one of the best known MIT courses. For nearly 20 years, Dave was one of the course coordinators for the Scott McCabe Bitmus Technological Course. He took a great deal of pride in the course and worked very hard to bring us some of Canada's most notable asphalt experts as lecturers during the two-week course. Dave retired from the City of Burlington a few years ago, and we're sure looking forward to having him even spend more time to pursue his artwork, traveling, and time with his family. David, we extend a sincere thank you to you for your two decades of volunteer service. The backbone of OGR's educational program is our small army of volunteers from the public and private sectors. These unsung heroes put in countless hours every year developing and delivering so many of our courses. You can see the full listing of all of our volunteers in the annual report. Today, we would like to pay tribute to three of them who are retiring from their instructional role this year. Hal Hume recently retired from a very long and rewarding career as a supervisor of technical services for the City of Mississauga. For 10 years, Hal has taught the construction layout and surveying modules in the general inspection and sewer water main construction inspection courses. Hal, a very sincere thank you from all of us.
Mark here.
For most of his career, Steve Sr. worked in the aggregate section of the Ministry of Transportation, so we're especially grateful to him for lending his considerable expertise to not one, but two of the municipal infrastructure training courses, the bitumen technology and the soils technology courses. Thank you for your many years of service as an instructor, Steve. Please accept this award. And Bart Kantners is not here, but we will acknowledge and recognize him for likewise being an instructor. He'll be hosted at the appropriate time. Congratulations, Bart. Thank you. Could we please have Assistant Deputy Minister McCausin and Greg Demers, the AORS President, to please come on stage. We're very pleased to be able to recognize the outstanding driving skills demonstrated by our next award winner. In fact, this is his second championship. The AORS Provincial Safety Truck Rodeo is the ultimate test of Ontario's municipal drivers. Under perfect weather conditions last fall in Chatham-Kent, 41 drivers representing 19 local associations were put through their paces on a very tight circuit in the AORS 23rd Annual Rodeo. In the end, Steve Kidd from the township of Selwyn edged out his competitors and came out on top with a near perfect score of 368 out of a possible 370. This was a big jump even for Steve from his previous record of 355 points, which was enough to win the title last year. Steve has been working as an equipment operator for the township since 2010. Prior to that, he worked in the aggregates industry as well for 4 years for the Peterborough County. He and his wife Tanya and their children live in Bridge North, where they enjoy snowmobiling trips south in the winter and summer at the cottage. Everyone in the township of Selwyn is extremely proud of Mr. Plow. Would Mr. Plow please come forward and accept your trophy as recognition of your championship? Almost as big as the Stanley Cup, Steve. Congratulations. Would Mr. Burley, part of your conditioning program, would you please come back up on stage? And I would ask now that our special award recipients please come in to accept their awards. Now, one moment you saw them, and now they've disappeared, but trust me, they'll all be coming back. Please be seated. We will start now with our College Proficiency Awards. It was exactly 50 years ago when the Ontario Good Roads Association first established the College Proficiency Awards to recognize the scholastic achievements of students registered in college-level civil engineering technology programs. Over the years, winners of this award have gone on to very rewarding careers in the municipal and consulting engineering fields. The students you will meet this afternoon have been recommended by their college deans for demonstrating both a high scholastic average and overall proficiency in civil engineering. They are the best and the brightest. Take note of their names. I predict you'll be hearing a lot of good things about these remarkable young people as they launch their careers in the transportation engineering programs. Our first recipient is Spencer Bagnall. Spencer hails from Fanshawe College in London, whose staff noted he is both an excellent student and worker. His professors say that he stands out as a college student with the highest grades in highway design fundamentals, highway technology, and soil management. Spencer displayed strong leadership skills during survey camp, where he demonstrated solid practical survey skills. If any of you are looking to hire him, he'd be a real asset in highway or construction-related positions. Hope you get some good offers, and they'll probably be waiting for you outside the door, Spencer. You'll be lucky to have this young man on your staff. Congratulations. Samir Berry and Wesley D. Poltee. I knew I would mess that one up. Wesley D. Poltee. In an unprecedented move, St. Clair College in Windsor nominated two students this year, as they are tied with a perfect grade point average of 4.0 in the transportation, engineering, and technology programs. Even though they come from completely different backgrounds, Wesley went to high school less than 2 kilometers away from St. Clair College, while Samir completed secondary school in Pakistan. At college, the two were classmates, friends, and friendly competitors. Their teamwork included spearheading the Concrete Canoe Club and the St. Clair entry in the Canadian National Concrete Canoe Competition. And academic excellence and teamwork are very definitive of the success of these two young men. You both go far in this world, gentlemen. Congratulations on a good job. Very well done. Matching outfits and everything, eh, guys? That's pretty sharp. Can hardly wait to get those ties off, I'll bet. Donald has achieved a 93% average over the first four semesters of the co-op civil engineering technology program at Mohawk College in Hamilton. This is an exceptional academic achievement in the grueling and challenging program. His supervisor at Lantech Limited gave him an outstanding employer co-op rating for his perfect attendance records and the initiative Donald demonstrated while learning on the job. You're off to a great start in industry, Donald. Congratulations from all of us. Jeff Desaunier. Jeff's academic skills have allowed him to excel in all of his courses, providing him with an average of over 97%. He has used his expertise to tutor fellow students at Loyalist College in Belleville. Jeff consistently demonstrates a positive attitude in class, shows an excellent interpersonal skills when he interacts with professors and fellow students. Congratulations, Jeff. Best wishes from all of the faculty at Loyalist College. Leanne Grice. Leanne is an extremely dedicated student at St. Lawrence College in Kingston and has achieved a perfect 4.0 grade point average. She has also demonstrated excellent leadership abilities among her peers. Her ability to engage with other students in the classroom, offer peer tutoring, and participate in numerous collegiate activities have a bright spot for the school's program. Her professors at St. Lawrence College tell us that Leanne is an excellent ambassador for the engineering program, and they have every confidence she will make her way in a very fine engineering technologist. Best wishes, Leanne, from everyone at St. Lawrence College. Stefan Priest-Carew. Stefan attended Conestoga College in Kitchener. He has attained the highest mark in highway design in his cohort for the past 2 years with an average of 91%. Stefan has shown an academic understanding of highway design and a great talent in applying the art of highway design. He is an outstanding student in all other coursework and is actively engaged in student activities. It's no surprise that his professors were quick to recommend him for a college proficiency award. Stefan, from all of us, we offer our congratulations. And all of these people you've just met will be sitting at the employment table outside, because I'm sure we all want to line up and have a very important conversation with each one of them. Our next award is the Michael Woodcroft Award. It's presented annually to the student of the T.J. Mahoney Road School who achieves the highest average mark based on the results of both the maintenance and construction examinations. This year we've had a tie for first place with two students earning 98.5 average between the two sections of the Mahoney course. James McPherson has worked at the City of Pickering for over 27 years. He has been a Rhodes School Department since 2002 and currently holds the position of Grader Operator. He is treasurer of his union local and sat on various committees, including health and safety negotiations. James lives in Toronto with his wife and two boys, aged 7 and 9. In his spare time, James coaches baseball, acts as the boys' swimming and hockey chauffeur, and seems to be perpetually renovating his home. James, from all of us, we offer congratulations and thank you very much. Jeremy Sherman earned a Bachelor of Science Honors degree in Geography from Brock University and then went to do a postgraduate diploma in Geographic Information Systems at Niagara College. After graduation, Jeremy took a job with the Niagara Region in 2008 and he accepted a position with the City of Port Colborne. After 3 years as their GIS CAD coordinator, he went back to Niagara Region as their Traffic Infrastructure Locate Technician. He continues to use his GIS skills to update and manage the region's traffic network. At home, Jeremy and his wife are kept very busy with their two wonderful children, aged 2.5 and a 4-month-old baby. Please join me in congratulating Jeremy for his remarkable academic achievements. And our Scott McKay Award is the next award presentation, is awarded and presented to the student who achieves the highest average on any two of the three Scott McKay Municipal Infrastructure Training courses. This year, we also have a tie for the Scott McKay Award, with both students coming in with an average of 89.5. Our first Scott McKay Award winner is Trevor Clark. Trevor is an honors Bachelor of Science graduate from Brock with a concentrated effort in geomatics. Following graduation, he did a postgraduate certificate in GIS, Geospatial Management at Niagara College. Trevor is now a certified technician with OSAT and is working on infrastructure technologists in the asset management services for the City of Burlington. Trevor, congratulations from all of us. Good job, well done. Our second Scott McKay Award winner is Brandon DeMeester. Brandon has been with the City of Cambridge for 20 years. He started off on a temporary assignment in their survey department and subsequently moved to asset management, construction inspection, and is now supervisor of water distribution. He is a certified technician with OSET and holds licenses as both a water distribution subsystem operator and a wastewater collection facility operator. Brandon, well done. Congratulations. And the next portion of our program is a wonderful and long outstanding Rhodes tradition that is dedicated to the men and women who have enjoyed careers of 30 years or more in the transportation sector. At this time, we would ask and welcome our Long Service Award winners. I think maybe now we can say to Paul the Piper that he is officially retired. And we thank him once again. I would simply say if music is required, I'll use my whistle as a way of piping people in. We have now our long service awards, and I think you can see by the amount of people coming in, it's a great honor and a great tradition that OGRA have in order to honor and recognize these people for their dedication to our industry. Our first one, 44 years of employment. Trudell Major, when he was hired in 1973 by the township of North Glengarry, it must be have felt like a perfect fit for a young Trudell. For his entire 44-year career, his exemplary service as an equipment operator, and he kept the road system in top shape. It's not just his loyalty that we honor and noteworthy. He loved to come with a new and innovative idea to automate processes. He's a great husband, father of two children, and most recently, a new grandfather. In the June of this year, he'll turn in his hard hat and is already grinning from ear to ear, planning on fishing and vacationing in the Atlantic. Many thanks, Trudell, for your 44 years of dedicated service. And there's a special note of thanks here from all your colleagues at the Township of North Glengarry. They probably want to give you a standing ovation. Richard Puccini. Richard has been a powerhouse in the engineering field since beginning with the MTO as a graduate aeronautical engineer, which then led to a variety of roles associated with the province's road network. His leadership skills shone brightly, from administration of municipal transfer payments for roads and transit to groundbreaking work on potentially provincial monorail transportation system. Along the way, he became a much-loved and respected supporter and leader of regional director for MTO's Great Southwest. His dedication included 5 years of service as MTO's advisor to OGRA, and 15 years on the AOR's certification board. After moving on to a directorship of the Ministry of Agriculture and Food, he joined the ranks of Dillon Consulting, offering his extensive transportation expertise as a consultant. His family always comes first, but a close second is his passion for golf. So much so that the PGA now stands for Puccini's Golf Addiction. Thanks so much, Richard, for all you've been given to the transportation industry and to the many organizations that have been a benefactor of your talent. Thank you very much, sir. And I should have added, and I apologize for that, that's 44 years of dedicated service. The next gentleman that we bring forward is 43 years, has dedicated 43 years. I wanted to give him a microphone and ask, if you look on the program, there's a name on there called Eric Hewitt, but in the middle, he was adamant it had to have peaches put in there. So we'll have to ask him. You can ask him that question afterwards. But there's no grass growing under Eric's feet, not now, not ever. As an equipment operator and later, forward person with the municipality of Kincardine, he dug in and was fully involved in all aspects of road building. You can usually find Eric at a hockey arena or a ball diamond with a big smile, cheering on his grandkids. Any men's hockey league looking for a goalie can always call on Eric to slap on the pads, mask, grab a stick, take the position between the pipes. Can I just ask, please don't let them yell at the officials. When he's not busy with his family, he's organizing RVing adventures across North America or lending a hand to his neighbors, friends, and even complete strangers. Another skill Eric has is doing barbecues for weddings and many community events, a pastime and truly enjoys. Sounds like everything good is coming your way, Eric. And from your many appreciative co-workers, it's been great working with you all of these years. The municipality of Kincardine was well served by you and obviously is going to miss you. Thanks very much, Peaches. Forty-one years of service, we honor Ted Hayward. Like so many transportation and works keeners, Ted started his career as a laborer with the Region Appeal in 1976. It quickly became evident that he was on the rise from a crewman through the truck driver to a subforeman and then a foreman. He was committed to keeping both staff and roads safe. Not only is Ted artistic, he even moonlights as Elvis on Halloween. We're learning a little bit more about you than maybe we should be. When he's not hunting with his rifle or his camera, he enjoys fishing, gardening, and playing with his own hound dog, his golden retriever. When he retires in June, his wife Elizabeth and two children are really looking forward to spending more time together, even at an Argo or Leaf game. You will be missed, Ted, by both the contractors and the staff of the Region of Peel, and your many friends wish you only the best in your retirement years. Thanks, Ted. Forty years of service brings Clifford Curtis to our mic, or to our podium. R.V. Anderson kept Cliff busy as a project engineer for the first 11 years of his career. The Region of Durham continued utilizing his considerable skills as project engineer in 1987 through managerial and directorship positions, and finally as their commissioner of works from 2003 through 2016. Last fall, he packed up his briefcase, took his family pictures down, and took off down the road on the retirement road. No regrets there at all. Cliff and his wife, Flora, have a great time visiting their children and grandchildren on the West Coast. When they aren't doing their family thing, Cliff loves to court Lady Luck at any casino. We got all these people. Look at this. They'll give you money. He comes across on his travels. Sounds like everything is in order for a winning hand for you, Cliff. Good luck with your well-earned retirement. Forty years brings Steve Detremont. When you're a sign painter, you have to be particular. And through Steve's long employment with the City of Woodstock, his attention to detail was legendary. It had to be perfect to pass Steve's careful inspection that led to a very successful career. The infamous 1979 tornado kept Steve on his toes during cleanup, and it's something he hopes will never have to undertake again. For fun, his favorite hobby is collecting tools, and he likes nothing more than taking his classic 73 Duster to shows. He also enjoys spending time relaxing at the trailer, but it better be a 40-footer if he hopes to cram his wife and all five grandchildren into that coach. Sounds like your retirement is all set to roll out this July, Steve, and the entire Woodstock community sends you their heartfelt congratulations. Thank you, sir. David Panak. If it had horsepower, David was all over it. As an apprenticeship mechanic with the City of Toronto in the early years, David was one of the 50 mechanics all under one roof who worked on the incredibly diverse equipment at one of the largest municipal fleets in Canada. He often attributes his considerable mechanical expertise to those formative years when he left to take up a fleet superintendent position with the Durham Region in 2000. That municipality equally benefited from his skill set. Now that he's retired, David is still tinkering with vehicles, but he's now more focused on his grandchildren and smaller horsepower in the form of ponies. Well, David, here's to getting a kick out of your retirement, only in the figurative sense. Enjoy and accept our congratulations for your long and dedicated 39 years of service. Barry Spence. For the first half of his road career, Barry worked hard as a road superintendent for the former township of Herschel. In 2001, Hastings Highland saw him continue his nose to the grindstone ethics as a lead hand and also an operator position. Anything Barry does, he does well. And being a devoted husband, father, and grandfather is his pride and joy. They say you can never look back, but in late summer this year when he retires, he hopes to really dig into the past and his newfound genealogy hobby. Happy searching, Barry. Best wishes of the Hastings Highlands will always follow you, and we thank you very much for your 39 years of service in our industry. George is another Grey County lifer who started his career as an operator in 1978. Durham area roads were his passion, and he soon worked his way up to lead hand position. For 9 years, he stayed in that supervisory capacity until 2012, when he was promoted to area foreman. Leadership figured prominently throughout his career, and as a union president, he represented his membership well. All that structure got in the way of fun, though. In October of last year, he ran for the golf course. Now that he's officially retired, he's looking forward to spending more time with his wife, Deanne, his son, Cale, and the many unsuspecting trout waiting to jump into his fishing net. Thanks, George, for your 38 years of service, and remember that the coffee is always on at the Gray County Yard. Ron Gibbons, who served for 38 years, they call him the King of the Road, and that Ron's name is well-earned. Expertly keeping his crown on the road for 37 years as senior grader operator in Collingwood area has given him lots of hair-raising stories about long, stormy winter nights and the days keeping those roads safe for everyone. As a determined Maple Leaf fan, you don't have much to cheer about then, do you, Ron? Sadly, he has suffered with lots of his like-minded friends since 1967. When he's not hunting, traveling, or gardening, he loves to window shop at the classic car auctions. When he retires in the spring, Ron will have plenty of time to do all of those fun things and maybe even pick up his guitar and play some real Roy Orbison tunes. Congratulations from your many friends at the town of Blue Mountains as you move forward in your new ventures. And don't worry, the new lease will come back in the spring. I didn't say that, they wrote it. Congratulations, Ron. Gary Crandall. Gary is another familiar face in the road building industry, and like so many others, he came up through the ranks, starting off as a grader operator in the township of North Dorchester, where he cut his teeth by the way of the people who led him into the directorship chairs with North Dorchester first and later with the municipality of Thames Center. When the dust finally settled after amalgamation, Gary's office at the township of Blandford, Blenheim, proudly supported a director of public works sign on his door. He's been AOR's director for the Middlesex Road Association, and in his spare time, he loves to farm and operate equipment. At the end of June, he'll head out the door where he hopes to spend more time with his wife, Anita, and their three boys and three grandchildren. Gary, thank you very much for your 37 years. Bill Garibaldi. After several years in the private sector and some time in East York, in 1985, Bill joined the City of Waterloo, where he rose through the ranks. Most recently, the sign in Bill's office read, Executive Operator Officer, Integrated Planning and Public Works. He believes in teamwork and has always gone out of his way to mentor others and provide exceptional service to the public. Over the years, Bill has advanced a number of infrastructure innovations, including the formation of the Center for Advancement of Trenchless Technology at the University of Waterloo. Ontario Water Works Association Board has also benefited from Bill's input and expertise with his volunteer work there. His family has supported him in every turn, and no doubt his strong family network has made his working that much easier. In retirement, we know that Bill will continue his passion for fishing and mastering the frustrating game of golf. Thanks, Bill, for all you've given the industry, and have a great retirement. You've earned it. Stephen Croak has served. When Stephen retires as the manager of Public Works with the Township of Selwyn after 36 years of service to the road industry, he has every right to be proud of his track record. He was born and raised in the township of Innismore, where he still lives with his family on the current Century Farm. He's a proud Irishman. He loved to take charge and quickly demonstrate his leadership skills by always seeing the big picture as well as being a team player. His smiling co-workers say that he likes good chocolate, a little hard on the outside but soft in the center. Genuine, reliable, hardworking, and fair. These are the words that are used to describe his character, and they go on to add, although he won't admit it, he's compassionate as well. Your significant and positive impact on your township has been a direct result of your leadership, Stephen, and they will all really miss you seeing you at work every day. Enjoy your well-earned free time, and thank you for your 36 years of service. Stephen Penfound. Stephen started with Lambton County as a laborer and quickly advanced to senior construction technician. Residents in all 11 municipalities throughout Lambton County recognized his friendly face, it seemed, and his calm demeanor and smile made it easy for everyone to say, now there's a great guy who loves his job. Not much got past Steve's watchful eye, and his calm manner led to the respect shown to him by his many appreciative colleagues. Now that Steve has retired, maybe it's time to strap on his leathers and take a ride across the top of Lake Superior that he's been planning for ages. Steve, thank you You've been a joy to work with, and your many friendships with the County of Lambton will go on for a long time, and obviously you are going to be missed. All the best. Thank you for 36 years of dedicated service. David Waite, operating heavy equipment filled with work satisfaction bill, nicely for Dave. He spent his whole career in the township of West Lincoln, making certain those roads were in tip-top shape. In April, he has big plans though. He'll sign off, join the ranks of retired, march out the door, try to wipe the grin off his face. Traveling to Florida to see the Blue Jays brush up in Dunedin is high on his list of things to do. He should know a lot about the game, all right. He spent many years coaching both baseball and hockey. This summer, his son Tegan is coming home from his English teaching position in China, so he and his brother Kyle will no doubt bring some excitement to the Waite household. Happy retirement, Dave. Enjoy everything that retirement has to offer, and many thanks for all that you've done for the township of West Lincoln. Thanks, David. Ray Wilson. When Ray worked for 36 years at the township of Hoek, he must have had a special closet just for his hats. He wore a slew of them, not just for his public works coordinator position. When they needed a drainage superintendent, he was it. He also had the temporary positions of acting clerk, bylaw enforcement officer, tax bill stuffer extraordinary. Ray was not only loves to spend hours woodworking in his shop, but he also believes in giving back to his community through his involvement with the Optimist Club. Have a great time at your Wilson Island cottage, Dave, and enjoy spending that extra time relaxing around the bonfires with your wife, Deb, your two children, and five grandchildren. Sounds like you have it all planned out. Howick Township is grateful for your 36 years of dedicated service, and everyone wishes you the best. Thanks, Ray. Mark Archer, 35 years. Although he's made his mind up to retire, Mark's having a bit of a struggle taking a run at the retirement door. The actual day he calls it quits is going to be a surprise for everyone, including Mark. Sometime this year, though, he'll take the plunge, close his Director of Public Works Springwater Township office door, and take off into the land of fun, sun, and relaxation. He'll have lots to do, enjoying his music, cycling the countryside, playing hockey, and spending lots of time at the cottage with his wife Anne, his two children, Maitland and Hannah. Don't worry, Mark. We've never heard yet any retiree say, "I should have spent more time at the office." Although your many friends at the Township of Springwater will miss you, you deserve this retirement and all of the freedom it presents. Many thanks and more thanks on behalf of your leadership team and your loyalty to over 35 years. Have fun. Bill Grills. Bill has quite an extensive work history, first as a traffic superintendent with the town of Whitby. In 2003, the city of Kawartha Lakes beckoned, and Bill happily took up the challenge of operation manager there for a couple of years until the city of Oshawa dangled an employment carrot. Off he went and settled it easy as their manager of transportation. In the final 10 years of his career were spent on the job as a manager of operations for Peterborough County. His wife, Katie, three children, and three grandchildren are looking forward to having him all to themselves as he retires this summer. When he's not hunting or fishing, they look forward to spending more time with him then as well. Retirement promises to even be sweeter for Bill. He makes maple syrup in the early spring, and lots of it, I've been told. Sounds like a huge pancake breakfast at your place, and we're all invited. Bill, you can count on all of us to be there. Thanks so much for your stellar career in the roads and transportation industry and your 35 years of dedicated service. Thank you. Shelley Kaluki, 35 years. If you're looking for a superb attention to detail and a team player at the Renfrew County Public Works and Engineering Department, you had all of the answers you needed with a smile to go and professionalism when you contacted Shelley. She paid her dues, worked with, and then sometimes even trained six county engineers over the years. It's now Shelley time, as she has every intention to pack her husband up, Zig, her two dogs, and go camping at every opportunity. It might be a bit of a challenge though. She's in the process of building a new waterfront retirement home, but at least she'll have some help. Her husband, Zig, is calling it quits on his own cement finishing business. From your many appreciative staff members, a hearty good luck, Shelley, is the message coming down from everyone who has had the privilege of working with you. Thank you for all of your diligence and efficiency with the Renfrew County. They are saying they will miss you. Bill Mason, fresh out of school, this young Bill took up a junior engineering position in the private sector. For 20 years and increasingly responsible appointments, he showed his professionalism and attention to detail to the finest level. The final years of his career were spent in the public sector as a senior engineer for the City of Toronto. Bill constantly looked for new and innovative ideas to improve the process and authored the first ever salt management plan in Canada while at the City of Toronto. Another first was properly designing a snow disposal site also at the City of Toronto. Following his retirement this July, Bill plans on watching the birds in his spectacular garden and the odd time bashing the birdies of sort over the net at his badminton games. Have a great time being retired, Bill, and although you will be profoundly missed at work from all of your accountants, your wife Judy and those three kids are going to be delighted to see your happy face every day. We'll see how long that lasts. Yeah, right. But all of us here wish you all the best and thank you very much for 35 years of dedicated service. Michael Farrell, 34 years, and it says, as a young laborer in the township of Brock in 1982, Mike was full of promise. His dedication to the job over his many years, there was evident to everyone who worked with him. His knowledge of the job, willingness to help anyone in need was always appreciated. As a dedicated family man, he and his wife, Suzanne, have recently welcomed their first granddaughter. During the winter, Mike always was seen doing indoor projects and had them on the go all the time. In the summertime, he and his wife spent a lot of time on their boat. One thing Mike has to admit that he has finally acknowledged that he will never be a great golfer. I don't know if that's something you want people in this room to know about. We think that's all right because he's a great guy. From your team players at the Brock Township, thanks, Mike. You were the best grader operator, and hopefully you're just as skilled at keeping your retirement road in great shape as well. 34 years, Michael, we thank you very much. Jeff Mitchison, 34 years. Jeff has a great deal of success in his career. The City of Barrie's acquisition of the CN line there and bringing in Go Transit had Jeff's mark all over it. Building the city's GIS framework and integrating asset management with the maintenance management was also another team initiative he undertook. He played a large role in working with the MOE to overhaul Barrie's ECA for the stormwater management too. It's the first of its kind in Ontario. As a technical operations supervisor, Jeff had everyone's respect. Now that he's retired, if you're looking for Jeff, check the ski slopes in the wintertime. Summertime is another story, as you don't have to go any further than Kempenfelt Bay. You'll find him windsurfing, kiteboarding, or sailing with his wife, Nicola. Congratulations and a hearty thanks, Jeff, for all of your years of outstanding service to the City of Barrie. 34 years, quite an accomplishment. Thank you. Paul Knowles, although the CAO responsibilities at the town of Carleton Place require Paul to diversify his focus to other areas, engineering has always remained his prime interest throughout his career. His guidance led to decisions that resulted in a municipal infrastructure that is the envy of many, and he has attracted numerous developers to community over the past. As a volunteer for a number of associations, including the MEA, Paul has been a strong advocate during his work on the municipal class environmental assessment process for over 20 years. While his employment ends in June of this year, Paul will be ready. He plans to pursue his passion for traveling, cycling, skiing, and enjoying good food. He's no wine snob, but he does enjoy a good bottle of wine. So no doubt that will be included in the fine dining part. Wherever travel takes you, Paul, please know that your contributions to the city, to the town of Carleton Place were very much appreciated and are evident in the legacy you left behind. Paul, 33 years, we thank you very kindly. Stephen Guy, Stephen is a longtime employee of both the village of Winchester and later as a labor and equipment operator with the township of North Dundas. Equipment operating at times challenging, and no one did it better than Stephen. Some people operate equipment, Stephen wore his, always with the focus of keeping the roads safe. Throughout his career, he has seen a lot of changes from the 1998 ice storm through amalgamation. He lived to tell the tale. Now that he's retired, he's spending more time at the end of a three iron, on the end of a fishing pole, or at the end of the couch in front of the television, begging his beloved Maple Leafs to win a game. A lot of people here are kind of whining for that blue and white team. I don't know. Thanks, Stephen. Your devotion and pride in your work is obvious. You've served your municipality as well, and for your many years of service are appreciated and well noted. 31 years from Stephen Guy, a very sincere thank you. Dale Buchanan. Dale has provided 30 years of devoted service to Floss Township and to the amalgamated Springwater Township. He must have felt just a bit dizzy, but through all of the challenges inherited in the process, he came through with flying colors and landed smack dab in the road supervisor's chair. Saying goodbye to such a well-respected, competent, and knowledgeable member of the team wasn't easy for his co-workers. Dale's family members, however, are delighted to have him all to themselves, and he plans on enjoying his two grandsons to the max. The good life for Dale looks like this. Charlotte cows and calves, farming John Deere anythings, Peterbilt, Kenilworth trucks. That doesn't sound like retirement. That sounds like work, Dale. Good plan, Dale. Stakes and horsepower. Although your peers are envious, they are sending you their best wishes for a long and happy retirement, and thank you very much for your 30 years of dedicated service. Douglas Kerr. As a development technician and project manager for the City of Scarborough, Doug's steady progress to increasingly responsible positions was a major goal in his life plan. There is no doubt he succeeded from acting director of public works and then manager of water wastewater for the town of Lincoln through deputy director of public works at Niagara on the Lake. He waited until June of last year to close his public service door as the summertime holds the key to Happy Doug. For his entire life, he's been actively involved in rowing associations both in Toronto and St. Catharines. His leadership skills are well utilized now as president of the St. Catharines Rowing Club. Happy retirement. Many thanks for all of your dedicated years given the entire road industry over the long and varied career of 30 years. Thanks, Doug. Alex McLaughlin, after 15 years working hard in the roads department of the municipality of Brock Alveston, Alex found himself happily set in the foreman's position. In December of 2000, Alex foreman level one assignment kept him busy and happy until he retired in June of 2016. Nobody seems to have seen much of Alex since, but rumor has it that he's grinning from ear to ear. There seems to be three main reasons for this: his down on the farm, his time at the cottage, and the best part, playing with his grandchildren. Thanks, Alec, for your sense of dedication, your sense of humor, and your common sense. Continue to have a wonderful retirement, and know that everyone from the municipality of Brook Alveston wishes you nothing but the best in your retirement years, and this room collectively thanks you for your 30 years of dedicated service. Dennis O'Neill, when he hopped on a piece of equipment in 1986, a keen dentist was looking forward to a long and varied career in the industry. He got that and then some, and finally landed the top job as the Director of Public Works and Development and also Drainage Superintendent for the Township of East Zorro-Tavistock. Now that he's retired, there's a lot on Dennis's plate. He is justifiably proud of the amazing things he produces from his vegetable garden, and he plans on filling many plates from his bounty this year. You can only garden so much, though. When the weeds are gone, there's plenty of time to go golfing, go boating, go fishing, and enjoy a long hike in the woods. It's been a long time coming, but after 30 years, it's time to sit back and enjoy. Many thanks, Dennis, for all that you have done working with the entire team at the Township of East Zorro-Tavistock. 30 years, Dennis, appreciate it very much. Thank you. Brian Poutney. Equipped with a strong desire to learn new things and take on new challenges, Brian developed a high level of proficiency in all things related to public works. Once these skills were mastered, public relations and supervisory responsibilities were developed and fine-tuned, culminating in his service to the town of Carlton Place as public works superintendent. Brian is looking forward to new challenges along with enjoying family time, especially with his two grandchildren. He also plans to involve his passion for hunting, fishing, golf, cooking, and finding new adventures with his co-pilot, Joy. Happy touring, Brian, and enjoy every minute of your retirement. After 30 years, you've earned it. Bruce Rose. Bruce started with the York Region Pavement Marking Division, operating a pavement marking truck. When he transferred to the North District Depot, he took pride in operating various pieces of maintenance equipment. The triaxle was a particular favorite of his, and he treated it like he owned it, always keeping it clean and well-maintained. Over his career, Bruce responded to every kind of winter storm imaginable, some of which necessitated him coming through the door at 3 a.m. or earlier just to keep the York Region Road safe for motoring public. After 30 years of service, Bruce now enjoys his retirement life fully and is very busy taking on projects to help his children. Profound gratitude to you, Bruce, from your host of friends and peers at the York Region, along with all of us here. After 30 years, we thank you once again. Jim St. John. Jim began his career at the York Region as an eager maintenance worker, utilizing his construction equipment knowledge from previous employment and transferring it into his regular maintenance activities at the region. He was very skilled at operating dozers, loaders, graders, and winter maintenance plows. It was not unusual to see Jim coming in during the wee hours of the morning during winter storms, and he never complained. His people skills were well utilized and appreciated by co-workers and contractors, and he was well respected by the new staff that he trained. He was always willing to step up to the plate and lend a hand. Upon retirement, Jim relocated to a new home where you can find him enjoying the company of family and friends. When you need a getaway, you can always hop on that Harley-Davidson motorcycle, Jim, and hit the road. Best wishes, good luck from your friends at the York Region and all of us here. Harry Wells. During his 30-year career with the Region Appeal, Harry's trademark was his smile. Let's just see, Harry. Attaboy. You just couldn't be in the bad mood with Harry around. Happy Harry was all-around good guy in the yard, first as a crewman, later as a sub-foreman, where he remained until he retired last summer. He's been happily married to Marlene for 46 years, has 2 boys and 4 grandchildren. When he's not taking his kids to hockey, he loves to garden, putter around the house, and roughhouse with his dog. His favorite pastime includes traveling to different countries, playing bingo, and leaving a fortune at Timmy's. He still smiles at the thought of it and has never lost his faith in his beloved Maple Leafs. That might be enough to take the smile off your face, Harry. Ever the optimistic guy, he's hoping for a Stanley Cup for the blue and white team in the future. Thanks, Harry, for your outlook and your perseverance and your work ethics. The Region Appeal won't be the same without you, and they, like us, thank you for your long and dedicated service. One more smile, Harry. Harry, just before you leave, one more smile for the public. I would like to thank Assistant Deputy Minister McCausland for taking the time out of your busy day to come here and spend some time with us. Greatly appreciated and acknowledged by all of us. Thank you very much. If I could, on a personal note, because when you have the microphone last, you're allowed to do things, I would personally like to thank Heather for all the guidance that she's offered me to go through a 2-hour program. Awesome, great job. And if I could add my own retirement notes, you will be missed. Most importantly, a heartfelt congratulations to all of today's award recipients. If you wanted to take some individual photos afterwards, this stage is yours for a period of time. There is another program in here at 3. So you're more than free to come up and take the pictures that you would like. This brings us to a close of this year's award luncheon. We have a full slate of concurrent workshop activities starting at 2:00. I invite you to please check your program and we thank you very much for attending. Enjoy the rest of your day.